Yes, you know this young man. You've heard more about him than any star personality in the modern entertainment you've never seen before. Played by Elvis Presley, was a tough blackboard jungle kid who became even tougher under the influence of his jailhouse cellmate.
That's right.
Jailhouse Rock is the astounding success story of this rebel with a voice that rocked the world.
I guess it's just because you were so square. Baby, I don't care.
Elvis's next stop was Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer. Colonel Parker had finalized a deal with the Giant Studio for Elvis to receive $250,000 and a piece of the profits for his portrayal of Vince Everett in Jailhouse Rock. Profit participation was a demand that only the biggest stars could make.
You know, Elvis had worked at 20th, he'd worked at Paramount, but MGM was king of the hill at that time, and I never forget as we came under those gates, I said, good God, Elvis, MGM.
I was sitting in my office the first day that he came in, and I got a call from the cop at the gate who said, you know, we got a real problem down here. We can't handle it. All these people are all over, and I can't handle the women. They're going crazy. And I said, well, you know, you've chased kids away before. And he said, I'm not talking about kids. I'm talking about executive secretaries out of the Thalberg building.
The first day, we all went out together. Elvis and a couple of his buddies were in one car, and we were in the limousine. And when it went on the lot, secretaries and people started coming out buildings, lining this little street. And then we said, my Lord, what's going on, you know? It was amazing, it really was.
How's your headache?
I'm coming all unglued.
Wherever the girls thought he was, they would assemble. It was surprising how level-headed he was about it, because he was so young. And I remember distinctly when I said to Elvis, Elvis, how do you feel about all of this? Isn't it fantastic? He says, tomorrow I may not be worth a nickel. To have that kind of adulation at this age and to be able to take it the way he did was remarkable.
You don't like crazy music. You don't like rocking bands. You just want to go to a movie show and sit there holding hands. You're so square. Baby, I don't care. You don't like a hard rod racing, driving late at night.
If anybody remembers the swimming pool scene, and we're doing Baby, I Don't Care. We did this all one afternoon. And they would do close-ups, and then they'd back off and do the long shots. Well, by the time they got to those, the sun had got in position. It was shining right in on the set. So every time you see a long shot, I've got sunglasses on. But if you see these two little black dots, and then when I go to close-up, they're gone. I've always thought that was hilarious.
Baby, I don't care. Baby, I don't care. Baby, I don't care. Baby, I don't care.
Over the years, Jailhouse Rock would become one of Elvis Presley's best-known films. As in Loving You, the picture had a semi-biographical plot.
I don't know why my heart flips. I only know it does. I wonder why I love you, baby. I guess it's just because you're so square. Baby, I don't care.
Jailhouse Rock focused on the darker side of Elvis's image. In the movie, he plays a brooding ex-con who finds himself thrust into the ultra-hip world of Hollywood.
I'm not sure how much of a chance he got to demonstrate all of his acting abilities, because the material was obviously selected to be Elvis Presley product.
Lizzie.
You might at least ask me what happened this afternoon.
What happened this afternoon?
I sold your record, that's all.
Swell. I could tear into a good steak.
Would it hurt you just to say that you're happy about it?
Well, it wouldn't be easy. When the money starts rolling in, then I'll say I'm happy.
I don't think he was ever challenged. I don't think he ever had to play a terribly difficult scene so you could compare him to another actor.
You like burgundy? It goes great with steak.
I like anything that goes with steak. I'm broke.
Well, if it's all right with you, I'll pay for the meal.
You will if we eat. Hey, waitress.
If you could say Elvis was ever unhappy about something, I think secretly he was very unhappy that he'd get more of an opportunity to act. He wished they would give him a little more freedom to do other types of things, you know. And there was a certain drama about Jailhouse Rock, which was good for Elvis. It was a naturalness about it that made him a good actor, and it's a shame he didn't get roles that would show that off to a great advantage.
Most critics felt that Elvis's performance in Jailhouse Rock was the best work he had done thus far. However, not everything he did made it into the final version of the film. These outtakes from the picture have been sitting undisturbed in a film storage vault since 1957 and have never before been seen by the public. Many of these scenes demonstrate Elvis's dedication to his craft.
He was the kind of person, if you had your druthers, that you'd work with every day. He was so dedicated and he was so focused. He knew what it was about. He knew what tomorrow's work was going to be. He certainly knew what the film business was about. As far as the cast was concerned, he was very careful to show everybody that he respected their ability and that he was a rookie. When the scene was done, Elvis was very careful to go in front of the crew, not for the crew's benefit, because he meant it, to say, you know, thank you very much for your patience. I don't even know why you work with a kid who doesn't even understand acting, but I appreciate it. He wasn't doing it to show off. He was doing it because he understood that he needed them and he had to interact with them. And if the actor, no matter who it was, if he or she said, I think it would be better if I played it over on this side of the room, he'd say, fine. When he hit makeup in the morning, he got coffee for the makeup and hair people first, then he got it for the co-star, and then he got his own. And the other pleasure, of course, was that you were working with a very bright guy with a great sense of humor.
Now that's a C major chord, that's a big one. Now try the G. Never make a guitar player. You got no rhythm in your bones.
Well, I never heard of anybody paying money to hear a guitar player.
Well, don't pay any attention to me. I was only in the business for 10 years, yeah. That's all.
Yeah, I read you.
The first time Elvis appeared on screen without his trademark pompadour, fans were astonished.
My first meeting, of course, was in order to discuss this matter of the haircut, which he was to have in one sequence of the picture. And as I had previously been informed, we could not touch one lock of Elvis's hair, so we will make a wig and then cover the sideburns as well. In order to make a wig that fits this well, it's a good idea to have a cast of the person's own head shape. Now when this hardens, of course, you have a perfect form of the person's head. However, you can't remove it, so you have to make a cut on one side. To do that cut, you use surgical shears. My assistant said, well, I'll make the cut. So he gets these and he makes the cut, and he says, I think I cut his hair.
There was a quiet moment because hair started to fall all over Elvis's shoulder. And nobody said a word, and finally Elvis looked at his shoulder and said, God, there's Frankie Avalon fans every place.
Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer was known throughout the world for its motion picture musicals. From Busby Berkeley to Gene Kelly and Fred Astaire, MGM had created many of the most innovative dance sequences ever filmed. However, nothing in their past prepared them for Elvis Presley. And no one at the studio had ever tried to choreograph rock and roll.
This is exactly the way it came down. I never forget, Alex Romero was the choreographer. We'd had lunch that day, and then we went to one of those little rehearsal halls. Alex gets out there and he puts on the song Jailhouse Rock, and he goes through these Gene Kelly, Fred Astaire routines. And
Elvis looked at me, and I looked at Elvis and Cliff, and Elvis said, hey, man, that ain't me. So Alex, being such a sharp guy, he said, Elvis, he said, have you got any of your records in your dressing room? And so we put the records on. Elvis says, don't be cruel, hound dog. And he said, Elvis, he said, there's nobody here, and I know this is going to be hard for you to do. But he said, would you just show me what you do on stage? So Elvis went through about three songs. And Alex Romero said, I got it. See you later. And Elvis said, what do you mean you got it? He said, Elvis, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go home tonight, and I'm going to take what you do and work it into the routine. And it's going to be you, what you normally feel comfortable doing on stage, but I'm going to choreograph it. The next day, we come back, man. And we go back to that same little rehearsal hall. And Alex Romero, man, bless his heart, he's choreographed this scene. It looks like you're watching Elvis. So Elvis went through it, and man, it was boom, they had it. It worked out to be the best dance sequence he ever did.
One threw a party in the county jail. The prison band was there, they began to wail. The band was jumping, and the joint began to swing. You should have heard the knocked out jailbird sing, let it rock. Everybody, let it rock. Everybody in the whole cell block was dancing to the Jailhouse Rock. Spider-Man played it in a saxophone. Little Joe was blowing on the slide trombone. From a bomb and metal bomb, a crack boom bang. The whole rhythm section was a purple gang. Let's rock. Everybody, let's rock. Everybody in the whole cell block.
It's funny because he enjoyed it so much. He was having such a good time. He also knew that he was doing a good number. He had a sense for the kill. He knew that this was going to look good.
I want to stick around a while and get my kick. Everybody, let's rock.
I think from time to time he showed real sparks, but I don't feel that he ever was allowed to develop. But I felt that he was an incredible natural actor and could have been brilliant had he had Stella Adler or what's his name from the act, Lee Strasberg
or
Sandy Meisner. If any one of those guys had gotten a hold of him, it would have been all over. I think it would have been as good as Brando.
You insulted my father, my mother, and me, and it's just unforgivable.
What do you expect? I come out, have a little beer. First thing I know, some old broads push me in the corner with some stupid question.
They were just trying to bring you into the conversation.
Well, they could show their conversation. I'm not even sure they were talking English.
I'll drive you back to your hotel.
I'll walk.
I think I'm going to just hate you.
You ain't going to hate me. I ain't gonna let you hate me.
How dare you think such cheap tactics would work with me?
I ain't tactics, honey. It's just the beast in me.
Elvis's co-star in this picture was a promising young actress named Judy Tyler. The two quickly became close friends.
He had tremendous respect for Judy as an actress, whose career was snapped short because of an accident. The collision killed the driver of the other car, her and her husband. Strangely enough, both vehicles were looted. And the whole thing was extremely ugly, and I think that it was very disturbing, obviously, to everybody, but I think it was disturbing to Elvis, too, because it was such a horrible freak accident.
I never forget, I was getting out of bed. My mom said, Elvis is at the door. So I went to the door. I said, Elvis. He said, come on. I said, what's wrong? He said, we're going to take a ride. He looked real serious. I said, damn, what's wrong? So we got in the car, and he said, hey, man. He told me. He said, Judy Tyler got killed. And I said, God, Elvis, what happened? And he proceeded to explain to me this car wreck. And he said he felt so bad because she had been a child actress. And this was her first big break, and she was so excited about it. And she got killed before the picture came out. And Elvis was very upset about it.
You're so young and beautiful. You're everything I love. Your angel smile, your gentle touch are all I'm dreaming of. Oh, take this heart I offer you and never set me free. Then you'll be
he was terrific in that picture. He had a naturalism about him.